simply because I have an immigration and an education in construction. Don't mention it all. Here's construction news. So I'm going to be site classes to do the wall. That orange pattern in front of us. Just walk. And you need to preserve the house site. A, can I make an animated distance walk? It is. Because of the holes in a solid part, can you jump around every time? And you don't appear to get close. I believe also there's a couple of defensive holes on the rear screen.
Here. You may need to focus. It may be more noticeable when I'm showing it than it is in actually being in the world of invention. Because when you're writing the phobia, when you're in the invention, you're actually then the charts and you see that the lobster mosaic slit into smaller and smaller lobster mosaics. There's a little bit of white cloud. Explore the mist a little bit more. And we're now sniping, not sniping to the side. What's that word? Strafing. Notice the mist when we come through the mist. Absolutely smooth, volumetric mist. Oh, there's some blue mist. Very handy. And a very complicated mosaic with little bits of mirror embedded in it. It appears to be some sort of gigantic rain rat mosaic with mirrors in between the tiles. So mirrors as mortar. Mortar mirrors. That's the blue. It would be absolutely impossible to do any of these things in a rasterizer, that should be clear. And given another order of magnitude or so of processor CPU cycles, this render would be full screen and better than any rasterizer could possibly be. So we'll have a quick scene. But writing one of these things is not so trivial. So when computers are fast enough, this is the best way to do real-time graphics, which they almost are now. There will be those who wish that they had spent the previous decade working on the algorithms. Maybe not many, but they will exist. As far as I know, there will be only one person who will not be filled with such regret. Not for the reason that he is not interested in having done it, but for the reason that he has done it. Those are spheres with holes in them, made up of tiny cubes. Ooh. Ooh. Mob of four. Ah, here we have a rotating axolotl. Excellent. Now let's get a mirror in here so we can see a reflection. Ah, yes, a mirror. A distorted mirror. It's actually easier to sort of see that it's a mirror if it's not a straight mirror, if it's warped. So this is a spherically warped cube mirror. And
after the wall and then strafe them.
Snipe, not strafe. Snipe. I will snipe.
Into the wall? Actually, you get multiple reflections for free. Think about ray tracers. You get almost everything in terms of effect. You just get free. Just falls out of the way it works. Colors cleaning. You know, radiance. There's no lighting in this, per se, or only the lighting. You can think of it as a point light on the camera. So that surfaces that are oblique to the camera are less brightly lit. But there's no other lighting besides that. I think Minecraft-style dynamic cellular lighting would look really good. And we're about to head out and attempt to burrow and make a secret hideout down in the Lobster Mosaic. I think I'll cut the movie off somewhere in that because it doesn't work very well. I get stuck. I have to jump. Ah, yes. So that's actually the maximum size of block that I can now remove. Or add. I put this constraint in. But it's, you know, it's artificial. But I just made it so that there's only a few sides of the blocks you can actually draw, or holes you can make. Just to sort of constrain the ability of the implicit avatar. In the same way I make it so that you can't modify boxes very far away from your present position. And just lovely. I just love working on this. Isn't it beautiful? Thing is, it's my baby, it's beautiful, I think it's beautiful. I care not what others may say.